You guys have an intro?
No.
No.
This is House of Snooks.
Yeah.
This is a special episode because it was recorded on the same day as the previous one. And we're mostly just doing it to tell a story of how we acquired this food.
What's the previous one?
We talked about Raisin Bran.
Oh.
a classic. So, hey, I'm Mustard.
I'm Be Natural.
And I'm Better.
Yeah, we have a guest here. We ate, it was like alpha plant-based chicken nuggets.
Yeah. And beef crumbles.
Mysterious beef crumbles.
Mysterious beef crumbles.
Wait, they're actually called mysterious?
No.
No.
Okay, I guess so how did you acquire these? Well, I guess context. You were staying at my house.
Yeah.
In my town.
Where there's no meat, where there's no, where there's no vegan stuff.
Yeah.
And I wanted some Beyond Burgers.
And we went to, earlier today, we went to this massive supermarket with like a billion aisles.
Yeah.
And they didn't have any Beyond patties.
Meat. They didn't have any Beyond Meat.
No kind of vegan like patties at all.
No, and they didn't have any kind, I don't even think they had any kind of vegetarian patty.
Yeah.
And they didn't have any, they also didn't have any plant-based ice cream. Like, they didn't have any non-dairy ice cream.
Really?
Yeah.
That surprises me.
Yeah. They had, like, Ben & Jerry's and stuff, but not the vegan Ben & Jerry's, just the regular Ben & Jerry's.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So after that issue, we were like, well, there's no way, like, any of the small stores in my town are going to have, like, any vegan stuff that you want. So that's the context.
And then, I called two places that were kind of out of town, but I was willing to drive to see if they had Beyond Meat. First place, a guy really disinterested sounding guy answered, and he was like, no. And then, second place, I called them, and they said, well, we'd have to walk the aisles ourselves and check, write it down, and then walk the aisles ourselves and check every package to see if it's there. And then they didn't call me back for, like, 2 more hours, but they actually did call me back 2 hours later and tell me that they did have it, but it was a bit late then. And so in the meantime, we walked to the downtown of this town that we're in, and there were two grocery stores there. There were two grocery stores in
one
quotes.
Of them was like basically like a gas station,
yeah,
kind of thing.
Like a convenience store.
Yeah, and the other was just like, well, it's well, I'm not gonna say the name. It's like I guess I'll just call it like Stinky Store.
Yeah.
And it's just so it says like Stinky Store just like on the side, and like in the, and there was like he had like, I don't think one of these other, but he had like lettering, like, you know, letters you put up like on a marquee or whatever thing, and it was like chicken, pork, B,
no F,
the F fell off, I guess, and I thought that was funny. I was like, oh look, Be Natural, they have B here.
Yeah, I didn't know what you were talking about when you said that.
Anyway, continue.
And we went in there, and it wasn't, and it, there was just like 8 like residential refrigerators, like not like, the kind that stores have.
Oh my gosh.
Just like white refrigerators.
Refrigerators. With, yeah, and they were marked like meat.
I remember one of them said like, open this door, because like it doesn't look like you should be allowed to open them. They look like storage.
Yeah, they don't, it's, you can't see, like, they don't have clear, like, you can't see what's in them without opening them.
And there's, like, one shelf.
So I asked him, do you have Beyond Meat or Impossible Meat here? And he said, oh, yes, we have Beyond
Meat.
Oh,
we should say, this guy, he looked like an old prospector man. Like, he had, like, a gray beard and glasses and, like, a hat. He was wearing a hat.
A cowboy hat?
I don't remember, do you remember what kind of hat it was?
No.
Me neither.
But
he had some kind of hat on.
He was like, oh, yes, we have Beyond Beef. And I was like, and then he's just like, he said that so confidently, and he was like walking towards one of the refrigerators, and I thought for sure, like, oh, he doesn't know what Beyond Beef is. He's just like, oh yes, here at Stinky's Market, we have Beyond
Stinky Store.
Beef. We have Beef and Beyond.
That's why I thought, I was thinking that too. I was like, there's no way this man knows what Beyond Beef is. Like, why would this one room building have Beyond Meat in it?
Because they respect the vegan community, that's why.
Yeah, good job, Stinky.
And he opened up one of the fridge, and there was like these chicken nuggets inside, these in a package with a, like, branding and everything.
Yeah.
And I checked the expiration date on them, and
oh.
Yeah, and it's fine.
Oh, okay.
It didn't expire until 2023.
Could have died some of those.
And it's 2022 right now.
Oh, this episode is also unique because we ate the food before recording. Usually we don't do that, but it's not whatever. It's
and then I was like, okay, and then he said, we also have these beef crumbles, and he just gave me these two bags, which are just two plastic bags full of like this beef looking stuff, and.
Unlabeled plastic
totally
bags.
Totally unlabeled. No oh label at all.
The label, the there was like a tag. Sticker that said like $2.99.
Yeah, there was a sticker on each of them that said $2.99. And then I was like, okay, what is this? And then he reached into the fridge again and pulled out a piece of cardboard that had the label on it, but it was extremely faded. And
oh my god.
And like, and I just looked at the ingredients and it was like pea protein and like that kind of stuff. So I was like, okay, I guess this is like, if this is the label that came with these bags. Then it is vegan meat. I couldn't really make out much on the label at all. And so then I was like, all right, I think I'll just take these chicken nuggets. That's good enough for me. And then he looked at me, and he looked at like the beef crumbles, and he was like, well, are you the kind of person who eats this stuff? And I said, yeah, you mean vegan meat? Yeah. And he was like, okay, well, then you can have this beef crumble stuff. I don't want it in my fridge anymore.
So he gave it to you for free?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, oh my gosh.
Yeah, and I made sure he wasn't gonna scam me or anything.
I was gonna say, he sounds like an evil wizard who is sending this stuff with you to turn you into a rat overnight.
An evil wizard?
And I was like, I made sure to like put them, when we went to the checkout counter, I made sure to put the beef crumbles to the side to make sure that he wasn't like trying to charge me for them, because I didn't want to buy them.
Well, they have no barcode on them.
Yeah, it was just like a sticker.
Yeah, it was just a sticker. Well, he didn't scan, did he scan the chicken ones either? Because you just pulled out your cash and gave it to him.
Yeah, so I think you tried to pay with your card. He was like, this won't work. It's like overclocked or whatever. I don't know what he said. I don't know how cards work. And you're like, you asked me, like, do you have money? I don't know what it was. We couldn't pay with a credit card, though. Maybe because it was below the limit, I don't know, but...
It was, well, it said you can't... It was, like, $4.98, and it said mm-hmm. you have a... You need to have a... You need to...
At least $5.
Yeah, at least $5.
Well, yeah, but I assume the machine doesn't restrict that. I assume it was just, like, a store... And he was like, oh, well, you guys can do it anyway. But then it didn't work, is I think what happened.
Yeah.
So then I, like, pulled... I, like, dumped all the... I have, like, a bunch of quarters and pennies in my wallet that I hate having in there, because every time I pay with cash, I get all these stupid change... I don't have anywhere to put. So I dumped those on the counter. And then he was like, okay, well, that's $1 with the quarters. And then I took out like four $1 bills that I also had. And he was like, well, this is a little bit under the limit. But you know what? It's fine. Today's your guy's lucky day, you guys. And
he just really wanted to get rid of those.
Yeah.
He said, get this out of my fridge. That's what he said.
So the beef crumbles, it was like $2.99 each, I think. There was a price on there.
Yeah.
They were free.
Yeah.
And
I guess they were in there for like 6 years or something, judging by the label, which wasn't even attached to the, which wasn't even, well, I didn't eat many of the beef crumbles. I ate one of them.
That's why I see you give us the label.
Well, it wasn't attached to it. It would be another thing that we had to carry.
Oh, you didn't, he just had it down. He just didn't grab it.
Yeah.
Oh, I would have grabbed it.
Well, and then you suggested we, after we left the store, you suggested going back in there to get it, and I was like, I don't really feel like talking to people again.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, honestly, I feel kind of sick right now because I've probably, but I don't know if it's because of the food or because I was talking to people and I'm anxious. So, yeah.
It was probably the food.
Well, it was cooked on a griddle, so it's like oily.
Well, I didn't have any of the beef crumbles. I had like two of them. So, also, I haven't pooped in 5 days.
Oh my gosh, that explains it.
You brought that up in the last one, because I was like, oh, these have fiber in them. And you were like, oh, that's good, I haven't pooped in 5 days.
Yeah.
So I'm not going to include that in this episode, too. I think
Well, it's the same day. I still haven't pooped in 5 days.
Okay.
So just for an update, Benatural has not pooped.
Yeah, she hasn't pooped
in
yet.
Between the recording of these two episodes.
Speaking of...
Between the early afternoon and late afternoon.
So my dad was making food, like, on a big griddle thing. He was making, like, chicken and whatever. And they were like, oh, we can make these beef crumbles there, too. So we took, like... It was, like, half of a bag. These are, like, big bags, by the way.
Yeah, these were huge.
So you have, like, 75% of the beef crumbles still?
Yeah.
It's funny.
And, I guess we'll talk about the chicken nuggets first, because, that's, I guess, simpler to talk about. So, you know, chicken nuggets? That's what they tasted like.
They were totally fine. They may or may not have made me sick. There might have been other things that have, that I'm, other reasons.
I'm pretty sure it's other reasons.
Okay.
It's probably just dehydrated.
The,
I've been drinking a lot.
Okay.
Yeah, these nuggets, they were a lot better than the KFC vegan nuggets.
Really? I thought the KFC vegan nuggets were better.
The vegan KFC ones were too, like, oily, greasy tasting. And, too hot. But these ones tasted like any, like, store-bought, like name brand packaged boxed frozen chicken nuggets. Like, they taste like dino nuggets, you know? Like, I wouldn't have assumed they were vegan. I think they're better than... these might be the best vegan nuggets I've had because they taste
really
like normal ones. Yeah.
Man, the ones at my house are... I don't know.
Those ones taste less like chicken nuggets. They taste... They seem more natural tasting. They're probably better. They taste less like chicken nuggets, though. That's all.
Okay.
Anyway, and the mysterious beef crumbles.
Yeah, the beef crumbles. First of all, they, like, weren't crumbly. It was more like...
I don't understand how beef would be crumbly anyway.
Ground beef.
Oh, like... I guess a taco beef is, like, crumbly.
Yeah, and that's what I would assume it is, but it was, like...
This stuff looked like shredded beef jerky.
It was like steak taco meat, like cubed steak.
But not even as, but not as crumbly as that.
The steak isn't crumbly. Anyway, what is it
called? No, not as crumbly as taco meat.
Oh, no, like steak meat.
Okay.
Like when you have a steak taco, like you cut cubes of steak and put it in a taco shell.
Yeah.
And that's what it was like. I mean, that's what the consistent. It was weird. Hang on. So you had one bite. What did you think of it first? I guess you can say.
The texture was extremely like soft rubber, like your mom said, and it tasted like bread.
Bread.
That sounds pretty good to me. Yeah.
No, it was just disturbing.
Interesting. That sounds. Yeah, it does sound disturbing.
I was a big fan of it.
Wow! Really?
I'm surprised. Yeah. Well, because we had.
I guess it tracks because it does taste like basically nothing else that I know of.
Well, because, okay, I don't like steak, is the thing about me. Mm-hmm. I'm not a steak. I don't like, beef is my least favorite meat, and steak especially I'm not a fan of. But this, like, took away things I just, like, it wasn't, like, thick and chewy. It was, you know, you could chew it fast, and it wasn't, like, dry tasting. No, I don't want people messaging me, all the billions of people who listen to this podcast, messaging me saying, oh, you just haven't had a good steak. No, I have. I don't like steak. Not a fan. It's fine, but
man, one time when I was like 14, my parents left me with my aunt and uncle for the weekend. I mean, for the week, but my earbuds broke, and I was like, hey, can we go to the store and get some new earbuds? And they said, we're tight on money, we can't buy you that. Then we went to then they took us out to a restaurant where the most expensive menu item was $100, and mm-hmm. the cheapest menu item was $35. Holy it was a crap. Steak restaurant.
Yeah.
The cheapest menu item was the calamari, which is what I got, because I didn't eat beef at the time, and I ate squid at the time, but I didn't eat beef. Mm-hmm. And I got the calamari, which was the cheapest thing on the menu.
Probably what I would have gotten if I went there.
And everything else there was steak, and it was like $60 for everything else. It was like, why? Okay, you clearly lied to me earlier.
Well, they were just excited to take you guys there, I guess.
And there was nobody else there. It was really weird.
Maybe
we went there
trying to save up all their
what
money.
What year was this?
We went there at like 4 p.m. and there was like no one else there. It was like very extremely fancy. The guys, the waiters were all dressed up and everything. We're like, what can we get for you, sir? And it's like, it was so weird being there. It was like at 4 p.m.
4 p.m. Wow.
Yeah, that sounds unpleasant.
My dad said he went to a restaurant like
well,
that
it was
once.
On yeah.
My dad said one time in his life he had a $100 steak, and he's like, yeah, it was the best steak I've ever had, yeah.
Nah, I don't care enough about food to pay $100 for.
Yeah, I definitely
Yeah, me neither. I feel like it would be too, that would be too hyped up.
I love garbage food, like.
Yeah.
I'll eat super cheap food, like, that's what this podcast is, basically.
If I were to buy a steak for $100, like, suppose I ate steak, if I were to buy a delicious vegan snack that for $100 and it was supposedly the best delicious vegan snack ever, that would hype it up way too much.
I would never,
like,
my
expectations
live up to it.
Exactly, it would not be worth $100.
I just don't value food.
I would
it's
be
a steak,
with every bite I would be thinking, oh, this doesn't,
I like
this
steak
is,
and I don't like it that much.
Is this worth $100?
That's like $5
really?
Per bite. Like every bite you eat, you're like, oh, this is a $5 bite right here.
Yeah.
I thought finish beef crumble, my beef crumble thing. Just it was. I was eating it with a fork, some of it, and it was because of how it was cooked. It was good, and it was very wet. And we had fried rice, and I like put it in that, and it was fit because we had chicken, but it was like these big like pieces of chicken, you know, or like I mean like an inch.
When he says chicken here, he means real chicken.
Yeah, we had real chicken.
I didn't have it. Don't worry.
I did. Which I put in the fried rice, and then I put these like beef crumbles. Like this tastes more like store chicken fried rice, because these beef crumbles don't like, taste like beef.
Mm-hmm.
They're closer to like chicken.
I was surprised at how little they tasted like beef.
I apologize because I'm pretty sure I was the one who just ate the vegetables in the pan.
Oh, okay, that's fine. I wasn't really. Mustard's parents were like,
they were like freaking out about it, but I was like, why did you put it in the same thing as the chicken?
Because it's
I was like, there's no way B-Natural would eat that, so I'll just eat it.
Well, I don't really like cooked vegetables anyway, but your parents were like, oh, you should have these cooked vegetables, and I was like,
because there's like no food for you.
Okay, sure, I'll have the cooked vegetables, whatever.
Also, it did not look like they were separated into their own little spot. Like maybe there was some at the side, but it seemed like random, if anything.
Yeah, I didn't notice either. It seemed like normal separation to me, normal layout to me.
Yeah.
So yeah. Man, now the beef crumbles, like, we're never gonna be able to have those beef crumbles again.
Why?
Why?
Because.
Are you gonna throw them away?
No, I mean, who knows what brand? I mean, once they're gone, who knows what they are? But that's fine. You know,
But you guys saw the brand on the packaging.
There was no brand.
It was faded.
Oh, you couldn't tell because it was.
Well, chicken. I didn't study it very closely because when he showed it to me, I wasn't expecting to buy it.
Yeah.
Right.
I didn't see this label at all. Actually, I was like looking at like the.
It was literally a piece of cardboard with a sticker on it.
Like an actual.
Like a piece of cardboard, like.
Oh.
Like 8 inches long by 4 inches.
Maybe I'll go in tomorrow and ask Stinky if he still has it.
I assume he gave all of his stock to you.
No, this still has the label.
Oh, the label. That's right.
That's all I have to say. And yeah, I wouldn't buy it again, but
But you would get it for free again.
I wouldn't go out of my way to get it for free.
Okay.
But
Well, but you're gonna go out of your way to go find the label.
That's true.
I'm so confused right now.
Well, I wanna see the label.
Okay.
I don't know if I even wanna eat the whole bag, but it'd just be good, you know, it's probably good for some stuff. I'm not a huge beef fan, but
you just force your parents to cook it and stuff.
Yeah,
I don't like it. You can
like
have
if they're making like beef, I'll go like, oh hey, make me those beef crumbles.
You got them for free, and that's I mean I'm not upset about it because we got them for free.
Yeah,
but
that sounds like a great plan.
If I'd paid for them, I wouldn't have been happy.
Oh yeah, if I would not want to pay $6 for these. I do like it more than ground beef. That's it.
What a good episode.
Wait, what's this episode called?
Story time. Story time with
House of Story Time.
Story time with House of Sntasnastasnox.
And how do you spell that?
S N T A S N A S T A S N O X.
Where does the T come from?
Sntasnastasnox.
Okay. What is this episode going to be called? Story time with House of.
Yeah.
Not just House of Sntasnastasnox. This is stupid. Podcast sucks. It's really good. Yeah, how long was it? We had an episode. Let me check how long it was. Because I want to... It was two parts. Yeah, we recorded for an hour and 20 minutes.
Just now?
No. Talking about wafers. Talking about the sugar wafers.
Oh, okay.
Not the orange ones, though. The orange ones were 7 minutes. Second one was 16 minutes. What did he... I always forget what he had in the second one. Do you know what it was? First one was 23 minutes. Okay, that's it.